My name's Gary McDonald and I've been here for 8 months.
My name's Kat. I've been here a year and a month, I think, a year and a month, yeah.
This is basic. They've got all the home comforts you need. You get electricity, hot water, everything you need. It's great to meet some amazing people here. Like, I made some friends for here. Like, everybody's just good people. Meet some characters as well.
I love it. Like, I'd say, like, we're all kind of like a massive family. So we all look out for each other and, like, especially like when it comes to doing things like actions or whatever, we're always like looking out for each other, making sure everyone's safe and comfortable with what they're doing. But yeah, no, it's really nice, like, because you're also like you're surrounded by trees and you go up the back and it's like in the woods and there's a waterfall and stuff and it's like it's really nice. The story behind the cherry tree is on the 6th of August 1985, which is 3 years after peace camp started, two survivors from Hiroshima came and planted a cherry blossom tree in remembrance to Hiroshima. The tree itself comes from the blast site. It is a clipping from one of the trees that survived. There's 10 of them in the world, and one of them was given to us as like holds like quite significance because of the base. Yeah, we get some support. Yeah, we've got like a lot of people who follow us on our blog, a lot of people who follow us on our Facebook, a lot of people who pop in and support us. Get a lot of support from people who drive past because we have a sign that says honk if you hate Trident. So you get like the positive beeps and you get the negative ones, which you can tell the difference. But we do get a lot of like good support from people.
Every day, yeah, especially at the weekends and that summer as well. That summer is visitors every day, like, because sun's out and that. Yeah, with sun's out, you get loads of visitors.
Large groups would stay in the bunk bed bus. If it's only one or two people, we'll try and find them a van and we'll try and make sure that they've got all clean bedding and they're comfortable where they are. Stalls, that's fairly easy. We just kind of like just sit down, say like who wants to go do the stall. We'll get all of the stuff ready, we'll figure out where we're doing it. We have site funds, which that's like that'll pay for like travel to Glasgow and stuff like that, and then you set up the stall. And we do have like donation buckets and stuff like that, so if people do want to give us a donation, it is greatly gratefully received, and that'll help go back into site funds, so then we can try and get funding. And well, we're kind of self-funded, but donations do help us out, because it helps with whatever we need around site. So but actions is something that I'm not gonna explain.